Have you ever wondered about the terms of a brushed ESC and how to choose the best one? Well, you've came upon the right place. Today we're going to talk about brushed ESCs and how to select the best one. I'm John Holmes with the longest screwdriver. Thanks for tuning in. In this video, we're talking about brushed speed controllers, or electronic speed controllers, ESC for short. I don't think there's really any other terms that people use for them, but maybe there are. Post down below if there's something that I don't know that they're called yet. So what we're looking at is a selection of electronic speed controllers from the market today. And what we're going to do is assume that we're talking about mostly a rock crawler situation, but this may also pertain to a ready to run rig like a Traxxas Slash or something like that that you've smoked the ESC on. And a lot of times people will smoke the stock ESCs. This is the Traxxas XL5 that comes in the TRX4, comes in the Slash, it comes in a lot of the Traxxas units. And they are pretty good, but over time they may fail, as many electronics do. So what you're gonna be looking for is a replacement. Now, what you need to know when you're looking for a replacement is essentially, how much power do you need? And fortunately, that is generally decided by calling them whatever scale your rig is. So if you have a tenth scale rig, then you would get a tenth scale ESC. And these would all qualify, maybe not this little guy, because we're really into rock crawling, and so it's rock crawling specific. But in general, you can say, hey, I'm gonna get a tenth scale ESC and go in that direction. But you want to know, hey, is it gonna have enough power for my rock crawler? And what else do I need for it? What do you want to look for in your ESCs for your rigs? Tell me down below. Now, what I look for in my rigs is going to be primarily low speed control. We want to make sure that we have the voltage overhead that I like to run, which is either 3S or 4S LiPo. And then I also want to have drag brake that is very adjustable. So most of these will come set up with 100% drag brake if it's for a rock crawler. If it's for a basher or something like that, then it may not have any drag brake set at all. And in fact, the drag brake is actually trying to mimic the feel of a brushed motor. So in a racing situation or a bashing situation, if you already have a brushed motor, you don't want to make it feel more like a brushed motor. What you want to do is not have your motor burn out, so you won't actually have drag brake on there. But in a rock crawler, which is really what uses brushed motors mostly in the market today, you want to have some sort of control when you get pointing downhill with your rig. Downhill descent is another way to put it. And for that, drag brake is what we use. And pretty much all ESCs on the market today do have drag brake. Even the XL5 that comes with the Traxxas has drag brake stock on it. Now, it's only on the XL4 version, or I'm sorry, it's only on the TRX4 version that it comes in there. And I'm not sure if you can actually adjust the other ones to do that, but it is something that a lot of ESCs have these days. Now, what you will also notice, or if you're familiar with these, is that they're all waterproof. Maybe that's not something that you want. It's not something that I actually use in my own rigs, but it is really handy to have. All of these three ESCs are waterproofed on the inside, and we'll just go through them and tell you what they are. This is the BRXL from Holmes Hobbies, and it does come waterproofed. It does not generally come with battery leads, so you'll have to solder them on, or you can actually get them soldered on directly from us at Holmes Hobbies, but it does have 4mm plugs. Next up is the Quick Run 1080 from Hobby Wing, and this one does come with a battery plug, but it doesn't come with any plugs on the motor side, so you'll have to solder that on directly, or you'll have to add on 4mm bullet plugs yourself. The next one is the Holmes BR Mini in a ready to run format. And this one does not have the plug soldered on, but you can hire us to do that. And it does have a 4mm plug on the motor side so that you can plug it into your motor. Now this one you can actually see the inside, so to speak, because we haven't finished it out. And the top, it looks normal. It's got a regular conformal coating on there, going back to the waterproofing, but it is not the thick conformal coating that we do in-house. But if I flip it over, you can see that we have already done the process of the conformal coating. It's nice and thick and shiny. It protects from debris, it protects from water, it protects from shock, protects from everything basically. And even if you're not getting into water, it's always a good idea to select a waterproof ESC, especially in the rock crawler world, because you may be next to a creek when you're crawling. There's a lot of rocks next to creeks, and one little mistake may send you over the edge. And if you fall into that water and you don't have waterproofed electronics, then more than likely you're not going to drive back out. And that's always a bummer. I've even seen friends get their rigs swept down creek once they got a little bit too deep and their rigs stopped responding. Have you ever lost a rig in the creek? It's not very fun, especially when you have to get in there and it's cold to get it back out. But I'd love to hear your story about it, though. It's usually pretty entertaining. So let's stick the XL5 aside, because honestly, not a lot of people are going to buy these as an upgrade. Let's go back to the things that I like in my ESCs. Voltage range is primary on there. The BRXL has up to 6S LiPo working range. Not everybody uses that, but I typically run 3S and 4S only. I don't run 2S. I don't think it's very useful in a rock crawler. And we don't have any rules for rock crawling. And so I'm going to run as much voltage as I possibly can to get the wheel speed that I need. Now, the Quick Run 1080 is limited to 3S, so you may or may not find that useful. Let me know what you like to run in your crawlers as far as voltage. But it's still enough for most people, even at 3S limited. And then our BR Mini, it will run 4S just fine. Most people tend to find them just as good on 3S as what they need. So it is what it is, basically. Now, it actually will take 6S, but the little brains inside this one doesn't have a switch mode BEC, which stands for battery eliminating circuitry. That little chip right there is actually a linear regulator. So when you start running 4S and 5S and 6S, that little part gets really hot. As most ESCs, especially the older style ESCs, they didn't have switch mode BECs inside. Which brings us to the next topic of the BEC power. Now, in general, I'm going to recommend that if you have a servo that's over 300 ounce inches of torque, that you run an external BEC, especially with these ESCs. Now, the BEC, or battery eliminating circuitry, is really what powers your radio and what powers your servo. It steps down the voltage from your main pack. So we have our main pack input. Let's say we're running 11.1 LiPo. It's going to plug in directly to this port here. And then your RX wire is going to put out a lower voltage for your radio to run on. And that's typically going to be somewhere around 6 volts or so. There is a range that radios work on these days, 7.4 down to about 5 volts or so. But you need to have that power step down for your radio somehow. Now, if, like I said, if you're running over 300 ounce inches of torque, you're probably going to need an external BEC. So this would be a good time to tell me how powerful of a servo do you like in your crawler? Is 300 ounce inches enough? Is 200 ounce inches enough? Or do you like kind of crazy servos like 500, 600, 700 ounce inches these days you can buy? So, you know, that's kind of a point that you need to figure out on your own, is do you need an external BEC? More than likely you do. No matter what, it's really a good idea to have that, especially on these brushed ESCs that don't have the most powerful internal BEC. But speaking of that, on the BRXL, it has a switch mode 3-amp internal BEC. And as I said, that's generally good for up to about 300 ounce inches of torque. Some people go up to 400 and it's just fine as well. On the Quick Run 1080, it has, I believe, what they call a 3-amp internal BEC as well. I would assume that it is switch mode, but I did not see any literature one way or the other on whether it's switch mode or linear, but it seems to be good enough for most people that are running 300 ounce inches of torque or less. If you're running one of those, I would love to get your feedback on what servo you're running and if it's enough power for it. And we step down to the BR Mini, and since it has the little linear BEC on the inside, you know, I am going to say you probably need an external BEC no matter what. It's just a safe choice when you're getting this small on the ESC. You want to remove the heat anyway from it, and anything that you can do to remove the heat will be good. And that includes moving your servo power external to the ESC. All right, so we've covered the power that you would typically want, which is pretty much the voltage range that you need to run. The amperage of the system, while it's embedded in that power rating, it's not something that most manufacturers are actually truthful on. So you may see something rated at, you know, many, many hundreds of amps for an ESC that's this size. And that's just really the manufacturers going by the ratings on the MOSFETs. And you can't usually trust those. They'll be good for a tenth of a second or a 1 second burst, but beyond that, the amp rating is kind of arbitrary. So when you're selecting it, just selecting a 10th scale ESC or selecting what your buddies are even running is always a good bet. Now, if you're running something that isn't included on this table, like Tekin products, like the FXR, let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear what you're running that has worked out for you well in a crawler. But these are the choices that I found have the really smooth low speed control that we use in the market, that have really good drag break that we need, and also adjustability for what we want in our rigs. But besides that, you get that instant reverse, you got your drag brake, you get your power that you need, and more than likely you're gonna power your servos externally anyway, so you don't have to worry too much about your BEC power. And that's really about it. It's relatively straightforward. In the market right now, there's not a lot of choices for brushed ESCs on the market, and so you don't have to spend really that much time researching it. But if there's something that I missed, be sure to let me know in the comments and we can discuss it. So I appreciate you tuning in today. Hopefully this helps out on selecting a brushed ESC for your rig, whether it be a rock crawler or a basher. Thanks for tuning in. Have you ever asked yourself, where do babies come from? If so, you're in luck. You know, whenever a teacher would like be at the end of the class and they're like, any other questions? And they wouldn't specify any other questions pertaining to whatever the subject was on cue every time. Where do babies come from? Every time. And after a while, they would get the hint. They'd be like, any other questions on this particular math that we're covering today?